Hello everybody, how's it going? Scree here, I hope you're all well. So this is the building phase for the new campaign. I guess it's episode zero, the prequel to what's coming. So enjoy this building montage.
Bye.
Hello everybody, how's it going? Carl Screezel here. I hope you're all well, and welcome back to Ultimate Admiral Dreadnoughts, where just before you will have seen a time-lapse, a fast-forwarded version of the building process as we got our fleet in being, because we are playing as Spain. It is 1890, and we're trying to keep the Empire going, because we're having a bit of trouble at the moment, especially over in South America, where we've lost a lot of land because of a certain nation that I'm not hovering over that's completely interfering and busy destabilizing every other piece of land in the area. But we do still have Cuba. So we've got a chance that we could still keep Cuba, but we will be going to war with America. Got to go to war with America. We still have some land holdings in Africa. And over in the Pacific region, of course, we have the Philippines. We have Saipan, Guam, Turok, Panay, Blue. We still have some land. But we are really suffering. And not in the best state either. We don't have a large shipbuilding concern, and we can't even build a battleship at the moment, so we're in a bit of trouble. So let's build some ships. So we'll have to get some ships underway after we've started the campaign as well. How many torpedo boats can we fix up? Two. Okay, we'll just do one at the moment. We'll build them. We'll put them on order as soon as the campaign starts. So let's get underway starting the campaign. So obviously some big changes since we last played. The world is now open in the campaign, and there's a lot of changes in the way politics works, things like that. So what we do want to do is increase tension with America. And we'll see how that goes. Finances. We'll have research up. Crew training. We'll have to go back 50%, I reckon. So let's get underway. Now, one of the other things that's changed since we last played as well is the fact you can actually design ships for the AI to use, and I've done a few ships to make it sort of slightly historically accurate, and it should hopefully keep it in a way to make it interesting, but eventually the AI will start designing their own ships. So we'll see some interesting stuff appearing. So canals are now open. And also you'll see these popping up, alliances. And I'll get into that when we get there. So we desperately need some torpedo boats. Pop 11 on production. I want to have at least 20 torpedo boats ready for us. So we've signed a trade agreement with Colombia. This is good news for us. So we have oil shared with them. We also have their ports as well as their fleet if we go to war. The big thing is, though, they can't build a fleet, so we have to build it for them. And what will happen is they will ask us to build certain ships for them. We will build them, and they will start using them. Okay, so we need to start sending some of our ships over to Cuba. Hmm. So I'm going to send two of our turret cruisers over. And two gunboats as well. Okay. Guantanamo Bay. We'll send two of the... We'll send a Blanca and a Lapin. No, actually, I want the Victoria de la Tunes, our torpedo cruiser. So we'll send those two there. And off to Santiago de Cuba. We'll send purification, send two purifications. And our torpedo boat as well. So it'll take some time for them to get across the ocean. Large industrialists propose redistribution government budget in favour industrial section at the expense of the army and navy budgets. Increased naval budget, less GDP. We should hopefully be... We're not going to need too much GDP at the moment, but we do need some naval budget, so yes please. Now, there's also land wars that can happen now as well. This is something that's new to this build. We'll look at those more in depth when they happen, though. So it would be nice if Cuba actually ordered some ships, because that'll earn us a bit of money as well. Advanced Navy Royals, so we've got... maximum of 7,000 crew in a task force, that's useful. Anti-submarine theory, not too much use. Okay. Now, our torpedo boat should be getting relatively close to finishing soon. How long have we got on the build? 3 months left on those. Politics. Yeah, who is liking us and who is hating us? We'll try and increase the French a little bit. We kind of want France on our side because we share a border with them. And we're going to lower our finances a little bit. So reduce tech budget to 80%. There we go. And we need to add crew as well. Okay. Okay. Captain use fuse. Columbia, it would be great if you'd start ordering some ships, please. Okay. Torpedo boats are built. That's some good news. Gun cotton. Okay, so ports. We're pretty... Okay, I'm going to send over a couple more torpedo boats. and maybe one more light cruiser. So, there we go. So that should be an okay contingent over in the Americas. Not great, but it is there. And six more torpedo boats, please. Ideally, I'd like some larger ships as well, but we have to do all we have to deal with what we've got. Argentina, Canada have signed deals with America. That's disturbing. See if we can improve relationships with Britain. Now, of course, there is a canal that's not opened yet here in Panama, so America has to sail its fleet quite a long way to get to us. But it looks like they're building up their main fleet in the Atlantic, so not really having a huge amount in the Pacific. So, could be interesting to send a task force over this side of the ocean. Maybe harassing the Americas a little bit. But we will struggle because we don't really have any ports close to America, so we're not going to be in a good state to do that. Majority of Parliament calls for immediate actions against the US. What's your reaction? The fleet is not ready for war. It's necessary to increase finances to prepare ourselves better. Or we could have a big chunk of monies. I don't think we're ready at the moment, so we're just going to go with that. We've improved our relations with Britain. Colombia, please order some ships. It would be really nice of you to do that. Just keep plugging along at the moment. 300-ton torpedo boat. It's handy. Now, probably want to have something down towards Santa Cruz. So I'll send a light cruiser and an tractor cruiser down to Santa Cruz. And we'll just move a torpedo boat down there as well. Okay. It's one of the nice things when countries order ships from you is you make a decent profit from them, but it does mean your shipyards are being used. Okay. Halfway to getting our shipyard to 2,500 tons. So we are getting somewhat closer. Australia is having a hard time. 16-inch torpedoes. are still. Yes, please order some ships, Columbia. Okay. Mexico signed with the US. That's not so much fun. Politics-wise. Okay. Let's see if we can improve our relationship with France a little bit. Good, good. It's working well. It would be nice to have a nice strong relationship with France so that we don't have to worry about our borders too much. Okay. United States sent us an ultimatum demanding financial compensation for discovered acts of espionage. Refuse, that's unacceptable. Russia is offering us a trade agreement. We can't afford that, so no thank you, Russia. Okay. Now, do I want to send a couple more torpedo boats over there? No, I think we'll have to make do at the moment. Hopefully, our fleet is. Well, it's not going to be stronger, but hopefully, it's just going to be. Well. Hopefully, our fleet. Our ships are better made. That's all I can hope at the moment, because this is going to be a tough one against America. We are going to get our asses kicked, I feel like. But if we can get early blood, we'll be okay. No, we're not modernizing American shipyards, people. We're about to go to war with America. We do not want to help them. Okay. Well, we're going to war with America. So, few nations dislike that. Russia has dropped quite a bit, but we're going to war with America. That seems like a perfectly good idea, guys. Yeah, let's see how this goes. I mean, the good news is we've got a fairly decent group of ships here. They've got a lot of their cruiser fleet away. Okay. That's a big task force. That is scary. And that's coming through now. So, yeah. A lot of battleships in their task force. Alright, we're just going to see how this goes. Okay, large encounter. So, they've got the Arizona. Charleston. Okay, so got the gun caliber advantage on the two cruisers. All right, let's see how this one goes. Let's just do a safety save. be interesting to see how this battle goes. If we can take down a battleship, that will be really good news. So, fairly decent weather conditions. Okay. All right, let's speed it up a little bit. So, north of us. Now, hopefully our light cruiser squadron should be pretty strong. We've got two gunboats, two standard light cruisers. We've also got our torpedo cruiser with us as well. And we've got sightings. Enemy is sighted. Okay, start turning, please. Just want to be careful of torpedoes, really. Getting a fair few penetrations, that's good news. Looks like. Okay. Good, we've managed to take down one of our light cruisers. Our light cruiser squadron's here. There's the Arizona. Victoria della Tunas, if you'd like to stop turning in, please. She's got some damage. Let's have a look at the Arizona quickly. Another light cruiser's going down. Here are their armoured crew, their heavy cruisers. Okay. We'll see if we can get a torpedo run on the Arizona. Another light cruiser down. That's good. That's all of our light cruisers down. Okay, good job. Now, Arizona's got torpedo range on us as well. Smoke up light cruisers. This is not exactly the perfect fight. Good, avoiding that torpedo. Arizona, where are your torpedo? Wait, do you have torpedo launchers? No, you don't. You don't have torpedo launchers. Okay, good. Getting close, and get some torpedo launches, please. Torpedo heading in, that's going to be a miss, that might be a hit. Ah, damn, detonated prematurely. Victoria Tunas, she's getting heavily pounded by those heavy cruisers. might get some torpedo hits on the Charleston right here. Beautiful job. Beautiful job. That's two of the heavy cruisers gone. Oh, we are looking great for this. We might even get away with this not being a single loss. That would be a grand one there. Yep, the Arizona's going down. Whoo, boy, oh boy. Great job, ships. The Spanish Armada has struck first blood. That is a big loss for the Americans. Using the Dakota-class battleship as well as two of the Los Angeles cruisers. And the Rileys just had no chance. That's exactly what we needed as a first strike, because that is going to really help us with victory points. So that is good news. That's helped us a lot. We've got some ships going to need some repairs after that, but proof of concept for our ships. They have proven very, very worthy indeed. Okay. Onwards to 1892, I guess. We will be hitting shortly. Victim among civilians are normal. Okay. Now, I'm going to want to put some more ships on order. So I think we're going to put four more heavy cruisers. Plank has performed well. So four of you as well, please. And four Lepanto as well. Might as well get some ships on build here. Hopefully our shipyards will be upgraded shortly. I'm going to need to send them some ships to do some protection as well, because yeah. Okay, we'll put this group out to protect. Okay, we'll move all ships out of port just on protection duties. And I think we're going to have to send over some reinforcements. So okay. All right. Okay. So we've got a battle up here, two of our light cruisers, and four of their light cruisers. Let's see how that one goes. And I'll merge these two fleets together, and we're going to start heading over there to see how we go. All right, let's get this battle underway. Let's see if we can take down some of their light cruisers. Okay, they're off to the north. So the Hanan Cortez has got a little bit of damage. Weather's a little bit rough. Enemy, they've spotted us first. Let's see how we go. Start turning, please. Think smoke up now, please. Detach. Start turning, please. I didn't mean to turn you, I meant to turn you the other way. Watch out for that torpedo. We had a torpedo hit, but it was a dud. Toria de Matos, please get in there. Okay, good, good. That's some good torpedo hits. That should make it start going down relatively quickly. Slow down a little bit. Need you to start turning in. Is going down. Nice torpedo hits, Victoria. Fargo should hopefully be going down shortly. I'm taking some big hits here, but hopefully. We can take a few more of these down before we lose. Get a torpedo hit on the Augusta. Oh, drat, this torpedo's gonna hit. Oh no, they might actually. Oh, looking good. Beautiful job. torpedo cruiser's doing a great job here. Oh, three duds. Hannah and Cortez is going down. Oh, that's unfortunate. Oh, and the Victoria. What the hell happened to Victoria? Where did she get flooding? That was weird. Well, that's two light cruisers lost, unfortunately. But three of their light cruisers. So, technically a defeat, but we really damaged that other ship as well, so... Gonna need some more light cruisers on the way. Okay, onwards to 1892. Okay. Sea control. I'm going to move this task force okay. Let's see if we can start causing some damage to their fleets. Up crew training to 70%. And our new ports are done. Great, let's get on to designing a battleship. Battleship 3 it's going to be. Drop down a little bit. Needs to be iron plate. Don't need a huge amount of deck armor at this period. Most of the shells are going to be from the side. Not top speed. Okay. So, okay. Okay, that's the Infernet class. 305 mm guns, fore and aft. Should be relatively strong. Mark ones, though, so not great. But much better than the horrible turrets there. Could go to Mark twos, but I feel like having a slightly larger gun caliber will pay off. And good penetration values as well, so should be pretty darn strong. And you've got good engine efficiency as well. Obviously, slightly narrower. But yeah, we've finally got a battleship that we can actually put out to sea. So, we'll put two battleships on order, and onwards we go. And we want to up our political favour as well. See if we can make the British like us a little bit more. Don't want to get on the wrong side of the Royal Navy. Good, good. We're starting to take some American transports out. If we could get an alliance with France, that would be rather useful as well. Okay. White powder. Improved relationship with France. And yeah, I think we'll call that the episode today. So a big thank you for watching. And I hope you join me next time for the re-emergence of the Spanish Armada here in Ultimate Admiral Dreadnoughts. See you next time. Bye bye.